हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माय ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज ओम मैथ्स कॉर्नर। टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस
एक्सरसाइज 16.2। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज प्रोबेबिलिटी फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 11 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज वी शैल डिस्कस events, right? So what are the main points in this exercise?
So let us proceed now.
First of all, meaning of the event. For the meaning, for understanding what is event, let us consider one example. Suppose one coin is tossed two times, then what is the sample space? HH, HT, TH, OTT. These are all the possible outcomes when a coin is tossed two times. Okay. Now thing is, if we say occurrence of head exactly one time, occurrence of exactly one head, suppose the name of this is E, out of this the total outcomes out of sample space they will be either HT or TH. Now this E is called event. Okay, this is very much understood that event is a subset of S. E is the subset of S. From the sets theory, the very first chapter of this book, we know what is the meaning of this subset. All the elements of E are also the elements of S. This is the meaning of subset. Okay, so this is event. So again, what is the definition of event? Event is the subset of sample space. Now we shall discuss about the types of the events. Types of events. What are the types of events? Here we have four types of events. Total number of types of events, they are four. The very first one is impossible event. Impossible event. This is the first type of event. To understand this, what is the meaning of impossible event? Suppose a die is thrown one time, and the question is, what is the probability that 7 will come up? Now we know that there is no 7, as on throwing a die, we get only the sample space have the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is the probability that 7 comes up? 7 is not written on any of the face, any of the face of the die. So what is the probability that 7 will come up? This is called impossible event. In fact, phi is called impossible event, because there is no element in impossible event. Second one is sure event. So what is the meaning of this sure event? Once again, the whole sample space itself is called sure event. That is, we denote this by S. The sample space itself is called sure event. Okay, next one is simple event. Simple event. So what is simple event? Any event having only single element is called simple event. Okay, for example, suppose a head is thrown two times, then sample space will be equal to HH, HT, TH, TT, right? Now what is simple event? Here first simple event will be equal to only single element HH. Second simple event E2 will be equal to HT, only single element, or like that. This is called simple event. In short, we can say what is simple event? Having only one sample point or sample element, only one sample element. Last one is compound event. Compound event. So what is compound event? We shall discuss about this now. An event having more than one sample point is called compound event, right? Now we shall discuss about the algebra of events. What is the algebra of events? In algebra of events, the very first is complementary event. For what is the meaning of complementary event? For this, let us consider one sample space. Suppose sample space throwing a coin two times, HH, HT, TH, TT. Okay, now what is the thing? E1, E is the event when exactly one head occurs. Exactly one head, either HT or TH. Okay, now what is the thing? Complementary event. We denote complementary event by E power C or E dash, like that, right? And E complementary event, this is written like this: sample space minus E. So what are the elements of sample space? They are written as it is, except those of the elements in E. So we write HH, HT is not to be written, TH is not to be written, last one is TT. So this is called complementary event. We also name this complementary event as note E. Okay, this is the note E. Algebra of events, the next one is event A or B. Okay, it means either A or B or both A and B, right? We also write this as probability of A union B is equal to probability A plus probability of B minus probability of A intersection B, right? Next one is event A and F. In short, we can write this as A or B or both. Okay, next one is event A and B. Event A and B. Symbolically, we write this as probability of A intersection B. Here, the symbol of event A or B was probability of A union B. Here, the symbol for complementary event was E power C. Algebra of events. In this case, the next one is event A but not B. Symbolically, we write this as probability of A intersection not B. This way. That is, we write this as probability of A but not B. Okay? We also can say this equal to probability of A minus B. This means consider A having 1, 2, 3 बी हैविंग द नंबर्स 1, 2, राइट, देन व्हाट इज ए माइनस बी, दैट इज इक्वल टू ओनली 3, 1 and 2 दे आर नॉट रिटन, ए माइनस बी इज 3, लाइक दैट दिस इज द वे इवेंट ए बट नॉट बी. In short, we can say probability of A minus probability of A intersection B. Now, one more form is mutually exclusive events. Mutually exclusive events. To understand the meaning of this, let us consider one example. First of all, we consider one sample space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and there are two events. One is A having only odd numbers 1, 3, 5. B is another event having all even numbers, that is 2, 4, 6. Now A and B both are subsets of S. Okay, so these two events are subsets of S. Now what we say, what is common in A and B, because A intersection B is empty set, so these two events, A event and B event, are called mutually exclusive events. So what we say, if A intersection B is equal to phi, then the events A and B are called mutually exclusive events. Next term we are using here is exhaustive events. What is the meaning of exhaustive events? Again, we consider one example to understand the meaning of exhaustive events. We consider sample space having the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? Suppose there are three events, E1, E2, and E3. Right, even the event having number less than 4, so the outcomes are, sample points are 1, 2, 3. E2 mean a number greater than 4, then events are 5, 6. E3 is number greater than or equal to 3, less than or equal to 5, then we have 3, 4, 5, right? So here first E1 is less than 4, number is less than 4, second is number less than greater than 4, and last is the case when event number, so say this is omega, is less than or equal to 5, greater than or equal to 3. Like, now what we see, if we take the union, here E1 union E2 union E3, that is equal to the sample space itself. All the elements of sample space, they are covered in the union of these three events. Okay, so this way all these three events combined together are called exhaustive events. Okay, so one more case we have, mutually exclusive as well as exhaustive events. In that case, what we should do, all the events, they should be disjoint, intersection should be phi. So here omega, just only we take omega equal to 4, equal to 4, then these 5 and this 4 is omitted here, then they become mutually exclusive as well as exhaustive events. Now we shall move towards the questions of the exercise. The very first question of the exercise is, a die is rolled, let E be the event, die shows 4, F is the event, die shows even number, are E and F mutually exclusive? Here first of all, sample space, when a die is rolled, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the possible outcomes of the sample space. Now, what is E? Die shows 4. And what is F? Die shows even number. 2, 4, 6. Right? Now what we see here, E intersection F, that is equal to 4. Right? So this is not equal to 5. So what we say, not mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive. Because mutually exclusive mean the answer should be 5. Empty set. Next question. Question number 2. A die is thrown. Describe the following events. The first part is A, such that a number less than 7. So what is A? Event A will be equal to number less than 7 mean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. What is this? The sample space itself. The sample space itself. Then this event is called sure event. Sure event. All the numbers they are less than 7. Second part, B, such that a number greater than 7. So what we say, there is no number which is greater than 7 on the die. So no element is there inside the curly bracket. Or we say equal to 5. And this is called impossible event. Impossible event. Next question, next part. A multiple of 3. So what we can say, C is equal to 3, 6. More than one event, more than one sample point. So such event is called compound event. Compound event. An event having more than one sample point is called compound event. Next part. A number less than 4. So D will be equal to 1, 2, 3. Less than 4 up to 3. This also contains more than one sample point. So this is also compound event. Next is a number greater than 4. So E will be equal to 5, 6. This is also event containing more than one sample point. So this is also compound event. Next one is sixth part. F is the event, a number not less than 3. It means greater or equal to 3. So F will be equal to 3, 4, 5, 6. This is also compound event. Event containing more than one sample point is called compound event. So we have A, B, C, D, E, F. Events, they are written as it is. E was an even number greater than 4. So by mistake, this was wrongly written. 6 is the answer. Now first of all, A union B. What is A union B? Either A or B minus intersection of these two. So A itself, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is, this is equal to the set A itself. This is the first answer. Second is, what is A intersection B? What is common in A and B? Nothing is common in A and B. So phi, and phi itself is B set, B itself. Next is, what is B union C? B union C, again this is the set C itself, because 3, 6. The set C itself is B union C. Next one is, What is E intersection F? E intersection F. 6 is common in the two events, so we write 6. Next is, what is D intersection E? Nothing is common in here, so 5. A minus C. So what we write here, we write all the elements of A except those of the elements in C. 3 and 6 will not be written, so we write just only 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 is not to be written. This is A minus C. Next is D minus E. D and E. All the elements of D will be written except those of the elements in E. 6 is already not there in D. So all the elements of D, 1, 2, 3, they are to be written. Next is E intersection F complement, which means E minus F. All the elements of E except those of the elements of F. So 6 is not written. Only 6 was to be written, but 6 is already here. So what we are left with? Empty bracket, which is also called empty set. Next is F dash. F dash means sample space minus F. What was the elements in sample space? A die is thrown. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Minus. What is F? F is 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. So what is the answer now? What is F complement? This is 1, 2. 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6 are not to be written. They are. So this is the answer to this question. Question number 3. An experiment involves rolling a pair of dice and recording the numbers that come up. Describe the following events. A. The sum is greater than 8. First of all, we prepare the sample space. Here, this is the sample space which involves all the outcomes, all the possible outcomes when a pair of dice is rolled. Okay, die. The plural form of die is dice. Two dice are thrown, then all these are the possible outcomes. Now, what is event A? The sum is greater than 8. So, what we see? Sum is greater than 8. 6 plus 6, 12. 6 plus 5, 11. 5 plus 5, 10. 5 plus 4, 9. Mean to say, sum is 9, 10, 11, 12. All these events, they are to be collected. Up to second row, the last element is 2 plus 6 is 8. So there is no element. We start from here. First element becomes 3 comma 6. Sum is 9. Next is 4 plus 5 is 9. 4 6. Next is 5 4. From 9 we start. 5 4, 5 5, 5 6. In the row with 6, 6 plus 3 is 9. 6 4, 6 5, and 6 6. So, event A, the sum is greater than 8. So, these are the possible outcomes. Next is B. 2 occurs on either die. So first of all, we consider this whole row. B is equal to 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, 2 4, 2 5, 2 6. Because first 2 is there. Second, we consider this second column. Here this is first element is 1, 2. 2, 2 is already written here. Next is 3, 2. 4, 2. 5, 2. and 6-2. So these are the possible outcomes. 2 occurs on either die. Okay, next. C part. C is the event. The sum is at least 7 and a multiple of 3. So first of all, multiple of 3 mean 3, 6, 9, 12. Maximum sum is 12. At least sum is at least 7. So only we have to take those events having the sum either 9 or 12. So C becomes, sum is 9. Here 3 comma 6. 3 plus 6 is 9. 4 comma 5 is 9. 5 4 is 9. And 6 3 is 9. Also sum is 12. So 6 plus 6 becomes 11, 12. 6 comma 6. Right? So this is C. Next part is, which pair is mutually exclusive? Okay, in the same question, which pair of these events are mutually exclusive? Here I am writing once again, what is A, what is B and what is C. The next question is, which pairs of these events are mutually exclusive? So here what we see, A and B, there is no element which is common. So because number 1, A intersection B is equal to 5. So they are mutually exclusive. Similarly, second, what we see, B and C, B intersection C, no element is common, empty set. Okay, so what we say, B and C, these two events are also mutually exclusive. So this was our question number 3. Now next question. Question number 4. 3 coins are tossed once. A, denote the event 3 heads show. So what is A? A is equal to head, head, head. And B, denote the event 2 heads and 1 tail show. B is equal to 2 head, H, H, T, H, T, H, T, H, H. C is the event, C denotes the event, 3 tails show, T, T, T. D denotes the event, a head shows on the first coin. So D is equal to head, 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 or head, head, tail, or head, tail, head. Only these are the possible outcomes, right, when we start with H. Which events are, number 1, mutually exclusive? Here what we see, A intersection B is equal to 5. So A and B are mutually exclusive. A and C, A intersection C also equal to 5, mutually exclusive. A and D, they are not mutually exclusive because first element this is common. Now we start with B. B intersection C, that is also equal to 5, so mutually exclusive. B and D, because HHT this is common, so B and D are not mutually exclusive. Last one is C and D. C and D intersection is equal to 5. So these two events are mutually exclusive. Now we come to simple event. Simple event mean having only one sample point. A is the event having only one simple sample point, comma, D also contains, C also contains only one sample point. So A and C are the events which are simple. कंपाउंड इवेंट्स, द इवेंट्स कंटेनिंग मोर देन वन, टू और मोर देन टू सैंपल पॉइंट्स. सो बी एंड डी, बी एंड डी आर द कंपाउंड इवेंट्स. हेयर ए एंड सी आर सिंपल इवेंट्स. सो दिस वॉज अवर क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर फाइव. थ्री कॉइन्स आर टॉस्ड, डिस्क्राइब पार्ट नंबर वन टू इवेंट्स विच आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव. हेयर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी प्रिपेयर द सैंपल स्पेस. दिस इज द सैंपल स्पेस, एच 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 टी एच टी एच टी एच 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 टी 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 एच एच टी 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 एच टी टी टी. नाउ व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट, टू इवेंट्स विच आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव. सपोज ई वन इज द इवेंट हैविंग एच 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 एंड ई टू इज द इवेंट टी टी टी. सो व्हाट वी सी हियर, ई वन इंटरसेक्शन ई टू इज इक्वल टू फाइव. सो दीज टू इवेंट्स आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव. सेकेंड पार्ट, थ्री इवेंट्स विच आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव एंड एग्जॉस्टिव. हेयर वी कैन कंसिडर ए इज इक्वल टू एच 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 फर्स्ट एलिमेंट, बी टू हेड्स वन टेल, सी टू टेल्स वन हेड एज वेल एज थ्री टेल्स. सो वट वी सी हेयर, ए बी सी, ए इंटरसेक्शन बी इज इक्वल टू फाइव, बी इंटरसेक्शन सी इज इक्वल टू फाइव, ए इंटरसेक्शन सी इज इक्वल टू फाइव. सो ऑल द इवेंट्स आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव एज वेल एज आल्सो ए यूनियन बी यूनियन सी is equal to the sample space, all the elements of the sample space. So A, B, C are mutually exhaustive events. So what we can say about these three events, these three events are mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Now next part, part 3, describe two events which are not mutually exclusive. Here we have, here we can consider E is equal to H H H, F is H H H, H H T, H T H, H T H H. What we see that E intersection F is equal to H H H. This is not equal to phi. So E and F, these two events are not mutually exclusive. Now next part, describe two events which are mutually exclusive but not exhaustive. Here suppose A is one event having H H H and B is another event all the T T T. So what we see, which are mutually exclusive, we see here A intersection B is equal to phi. So A and B are mutually exclusive, but as A union B is not equal to the sample, whole sample space, so they are not mutually, they are not exhaustive events. Next, three events which are mutually exclusive but not exhaustive. Here suppose A is the first event H H H, B is the next event H H T H T H T T T H H, and C is the event T T T. So what we see here, A intersection B is equal to phi, comma B intersection C also equal to phi, comma A intersection C also equal to phi. Mean to say A, B, C are mutually exclusive events, but union B union C, they can know they are not making the whole sample space, are not equal to sample space. So these events A, B, C events are not exhaustive. Next part. Next question. Question number 6. Two dice are thrown. The events A, B and C are as follows. A is the event getting an even number on the first die. In roster form, we can write 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, etc. These are the elements A getting an even number on the first die. 2 is even number, 4 is even number, 6 is even number. B getting an odd number on the first die. Again, in roster form, we can write this as odd number is at first place. 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 3, odd number is first. 5, 5, 1, 3, 5 are the odd numbers. Next, C is getting the sum of the numbers less than or equal to 5. Here, C will be equal to in roster form 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Sum is less than or equal to 5. 1 plus 4, 5, 2 plus 3, 5, 3 plus 2, 5, 4 plus 1, 5. Less than or equal to, right? So this way, C getting the sum of numbers less than or equal to 5. Now what is the question? Describe the events. First part, A complement. A complement is equal to sample space minus A. In sample space, we subtract all the elements which are in set A, then we are left with B. Here, 2, 4, 6, even number, getting even number on the first die, getting odd number on the first die. So, what is the answer of first part? B. Now, second is not B. We also write not B equal to B complement. Again, like this, we have sample space minus B. Out of sample space, all the elements of B are subtracted. Then what we are left with? A. So this will be equal to A, set A, getting an even number. If getting odd number are not there in sample space, then what is there in sample space? Getting an even number on the first die. Next part. A or B. A or B mean A union B. If we combine A and B, what happens? All the elements of sample space, they are there. Okay? So, sample space itself is equal to A or B. Next part. A and B. What you see? What is common in A and B? Here, A intersection B, nothing is common. They are mutually exclusive events. So empty set. A intersection B equal to A and B. Next is part number 5. A but not C. It means A minus C. A, all the elements of A and these elements which are in C, they are not to be written. Okay, so we are not writing here 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. We are starting from 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Next, we are not writing here 4, 1. We are writing onward 4, 2, like this. All the elements of row A, row third row, they are as it is. So this way, this is A but not C. Next part, B or C, it mean B union C. So elements, all the elements of B as well as those of in C. This way, first row of B as it is, second row of B as it is, no change. fourth row of C, 4-1 as it is. Last row of B as it is. So this is B or C, or to say B union C. Next part. B and C mean to say B intersection C. What is common in B and C? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. Next is 3, 1, 3, 2. Only these elements are common. So B and C, this is the answer. Next part. A intersection note B, note C, or A intersection B complement intersection C complement. It means we are required to write all the elements of set A. But which are the elements in set B? Common, they are not to be written. C, they are not to be written. So what we do here? So here the answer is 2, 4. That is 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. Because they are in event C, complement of C, they are subtracted. So we start from 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Next 4, this line. 4, 1 is already here in C, so we subtracted that. We started with 4, 2, 4, 3 and onward up to 4, 6. Last third row of A as it is. So this is the answer of A intersection B complement C complement. Or to say we can write this as A intersection B complement intersection C complement is equal to A minus B minus C. Okay, what is the result? Both from A we have to subtract B and C. So this was our question number 6. Now next question. Question number 7, the statement is same as this was question number in question number 6. Refer to question number 6. So I have written the same in statement in question number 7, but the way of question is different. What is that? State true or false. Give reason for your answer. The very first part is A and B are mutually exclusive. Of course, A and B are mutually exclusive, because A intersection B is equal to phi. If intersection is phi, so the events are called mutually exclusive. Next is A and B are mutually exclusive and exhaustive. So again, the answer is yes, because number 1, A intersection B is equal to phi. Okay, so they are mutually exclusive. Number 2, A union B is equal to the sample space, the whole sample space. So these two events, A and B, are mutually exclusive as well as exhaustive. Next, part number 3, A is equal to B complement. So what is A? A is this, and what is A complement? A complement is equal to sample space minus A, and that is equal to B. So A complement is B. Similarly, what is B complement? This is equal to sample space minus B, that is equal to A. So B complement is equal to A. So what we say? Yes, true. Next part. A and C are mutually exclusive. This is A and this is C. We see that because A intersection C is not equal to phi. So A and C are not mutually exclusive. These are not mutually exclusive. A and B complement are mutually exclusive. Here, first of all, what is B complement? This is equal to sample space minus B. So sample space minus B, getting an odd number subtracted, then we are left with A. So and A is equal to B complement. So what we are saying here, A intersection B complement is not equal to phi. So A and B complement are not mutually exclusive. Therefore, not true. This is false. Right? Next part. This is the last part, part number 6. A complement, B complement and C are mutually exclusive and exhaustive. First of all, what is A complement? This is B. Getting an even number, its complement is getting odd number. And what is B complement? Getting odd number, this is subtracted from sample space. So A is the answer. And C, what is C? Getting the sum less than or equal to 5. This is already given here, right? So A, B, C are mutually exclusive. But we see A complement intersection B complement is equal to 5. This is okay. These two events are mutually exclusive, right? A complement intersection C, that is B intersection C. B intersection C is not equal to phi. Similarly, B complement intersection C is not equal to phi. So these three events are not mutually exclusive. Okay? So we cannot say that they are mutually exclusive as well as exhaustive. Of course, they are exhaustive. If we take the union of A complement union B complement union C, that is equal to sample space, the whole sample space. So it means they are exhaustive. Of course, the events are exhaustive, but